Yonko Maker.
Let's go rescue the notorious SNO.
Bad news from the exterior.
Off the tip. Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. Taking a look at Los Angeles. The dunkers, Griffin and Jordan, are the bigs. Patrick Beverly out there with Rivers, and it's Gallinari in its small forward. Now here's Griffin. It's stolen by Randall. And here's the pass. Great pumps and away. DeAndre Jordan grabs the miss. Los Angeles on D. And Julius Randle, a good ball handler for his size.
Yeah, and you know what, Kevin? He's like our colleague, a left-hander. I mean, he loves to attack off the bounce, and whether he's working from the elbows or hauling down the defensive rebound and taking it the full length of the court, he wants to get to the basket off the dribble.
A free throw drops for Rivers. And here are the Lakers. It's a three-point game. Clarkson is screen on Beverly. Pass to Clarkson. From 12 feet out, and it's in off the backboard.
And you got to give it up for Clarkson. I mean, he's a natural from mid-range.
Beverly, the pass to Griffin. Jordan, the screen. Rivers dishes to Gallinari. Pocket six. Good for the basket. Starting off one for one with that shot.
Well, Merry Christmas. I mean, that was a freebie.
We call that a high percentage shot. And when he's the guy taking it, I'd even say it's automatic.
Here's Lopez. And no good that time. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. And we're about a minute and a half into the first quarter. Inside, here's Gallinari. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
Well, I'll tell you what, guys, he's an extremely strong finisher. I'm surprised he wasn't able to power that through the defense.
Fires from 14. A shot by Clarkson, no good.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good look.
Jordan the screen. And Beverly kicks to Rivers. Beverly beyond the arc. It's up and it's off the mark. He's over one. Ball the pass to Lopez. Ball defended by Beverly. Jordan with some nice D. For Los Angeles, they've gone 2 for 4 from the field so far. Jordan the screen. Beverly dishes to Gallinari. Pass to Jordan. And again, the Clippers missing. Lakers trailed by 3. They've been struggling here in offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Kicks it to Lopez. 17-foot shot on the way. What a play!
Shot there. I mean, he was calm, he was poised, didn't rush it at all. You gotta tip your hat to him. That was well done.
And Blake Griffin grew up playing the game alongside his older brother. His dad was his coach, and he credits his brother for inspiring him to work his craft.
You know, watching him kind of go through the process of he started to get, you know, recruited by college coaches, and then he, you know, really took his game and became serious about it. And I watched his work ethic, and I watched how he, you know, put the time in, the things he did, and that's kind of where I developed mine.
Well, talking about taking the right course, we know that the older brother of Blake Griffin, 3 years older, you know, he played, as did Blake, for their dad Tommy in high school, and they were terrific high school players and 4-time state champions.
I mean, it always helps to have a big brother who's kind of been there and done that. that they can share those experiences with you. Doesn't hurt to have a dad also who's a pro player either, and also a college coach.
And off we go, a close game, now starting the second quarter. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far?
It's all about their defense. They have just done a terrific job of negating the timing and spacing of their opponent.
Every shot is challenged and challenged well.
Setting the floor for the Clippers. They've got Decker. Jordan is out there with Hill. Then it's Williams. And it's Teodosic in the corner. The 10 foot. He can't hit that time. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. And the foul on Larry Nance Jr. That is his first foul of the game.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Greg, those are always tough to judge, but I think the official got that one right.
Jordan, the screen. Here's Teodosic. He dishes it to Decker. On the wing, Williams. Covered by Brewer. Nance with the rebound. The Lakers in the lead. And Larry Nance Jr., the 27th pick in the 2015 draft out of Wyoming. His father played, of course, 13 years in the NBA. Larry Nance has seen three-time All-Star. That is the league's first ever slam dunk contest champion.
And just like his pops, Junior is long and explosive. He can put you on a highlight reel and posterize you when he gets around that rim if you're not paying attention.
Now Williams. Larry Nance missing from long range. Williams kicks to Jordan. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Williams.
Always a threat to score. Williams draws defensive attention. I mean, that allows him to set up his teammates.
And stolen by Hill. Clippers have gone 1-3 to start out the second quarter. And we're about 2 minutes into the second quarter. Here's Teodosic looking for his first basket still in this one. Shot clock at 2 on deep. Williams' shot is up. The Lakers trip.
I like the move to go 2-for-1.
So do I, Greg. I mean, I agree with you. They need to get a quick look and then try to get another possession after that.
And again, the Lakers, no good. And here is Los Angeles now. Only giving up 2 points this quarter. Jordan. It's good. It's his second basket. He's shooting 2-for-4.
Now, that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active and be ready as soon as the shot goes up.
Brewer, the pass to Nance. Outside down. To the paint, here's Zubac, and the bucket counts, and he's going to go to the free throw line, trying to make it a three-point play.
Sharp pass to set up that high percentage shot in close.
Lakers shooting their first free throw of the contest.
And it's been an average year, really, at the free throw line for this group, only around 75%.
You know, they've really put themselves behind the eight ball in so many of their games because they just have not been able to knock down those foul shots.
Number two, about 2 minutes gone by. And Beverly kicks to Griffin. And it's stolen by Randle. And so it's tied as we head to halftime. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson, joined by Kenny Smith, right there. And Shaquille O'Neal. He's right there. Welcome to the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. A competitive matchup for the Lakers in the first quarter. They never trailed by more than 3 points, and it was neck and neck the entire period. If you look at the second quarter scoring, they had a small edge. They really hung tough as we got close to halftime. And taking a look at the Lakers, Shaq, what you think?
Well, on offense, I like to see them play inside out more. Attack the basket, generate easy points. And then once the defense collapses, kick it out to the perimeter for open looks. Trust me, I know. Rick Fox, Big Shot Bob, that's all we did.
Kenny, what's your take on the Clippers? I was surprised at how comfortable they seemed here on the road. The hostile crowd, that didn't bother them at all. And I want to see if they can keep that up in the second half. All right, that is going to wrap up our halftime report, as it's just about time for the start of the third quarter.
Both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break in halftime. We'll see now if one can pull out away here in the third. The wings. Julius Randle is out there with Brooke Lopez, and it's Ball in at the one spot. And that's the group for Luke Walton as we begin the second half. Now here's Lopez. Takes it into the top of the end and converts the layup. Lopez has got the first basket of the third quarter for the Lakers.
Among the most polished post scorers in the league, Lopez is a throwback player in a lot of different ways. I mean, he's that classic inside scoring threat.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Olson.
We know Brooke Lopez is a great post scorer, but he can shoot it too. Growing up with big brothers, he said, I have to score somehow, and it's easier to play outside. I was out on the wing a lot in high school running the floor. I had to adapt. But Kevin, it's hard to picture him on the wing now. He's comfortable.
Yeah, but he brings that skill level to the air. You can see that. Thank you. And with the size and footwork Lopez possesses, it's tough for one man to stop him.
It really is. The size, the soft hands, the know-how with the back to the basket. Pretty much can get his shot anytime.
Oh, here's Lopez. On the miss by Griffin. And that one, good.
Really hard to bother Lopez on his jumpers. I mean, he's just so big, and he has a pretty high release point, too.
Jordan, the screen. Lopez against Gallinari. And the layup's good off the glass. Gallinari's got the game tied up here for Los Angeles.
I'll tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move for the week.
To the paint. And the dunk by Lopez.
Hey guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up shots. Right there.
Yeah, you're right. It's very clear defensively. Lennon will get all the way to the basket that time.
Well, only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt, but still, it only counts for two. Two is all.
And that one's good. Beverly.
Not fazed at all by having a bigger defender on him down low. And I really thought he would be.
You know, at first glance, you wouldn't think that he'd be comfortable in that particular situation. But well, I tell you what, he didn't look like he was out of his element at all right there.
And that one drops for
him. Shooting here in the second half, their field goal percentage over 50% now for the game.
Yeah, it's not a surprise then to see them out in front the way they've been efficient offensively in this half and actually throughout the entire game.
Passes it to Griffin. He's looking for Jordan and finds him. And it's sent back to Lopez.
You see Lopez cracking that shot the whole way. Nice awareness from him and terrific rejection as well.
Now here's Randle. He's been patient so far, nothing more on the scoreboard.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam, using some muscle,
some urgency from him there.
Sure. I get the feeling, guys, that he may be sensing that this is a critical time in this game.
Griffin dishes to Beverly. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Griffin. Beverly's got four this quarter.
Boy, just a lovely dish by Griffin.
It's still anybody's game as we've reached the end of three. Lakers lead by two. And we're coming right back after this break to get the fourth quarter underway.
He was my nemesis, but he was also the club's best hope. Losing the race proves my pride. Smashing into the stairs.
And now we take a look back to Doc Rivers talking to his team from his huddle.
Hey, guys, we need a run right here. Come on now. You're right there. You're right there. All right, let's go.
And sensing the need to string together more baskets, Doc Rivers giving his team a little pep talk.
Yeah, he's going after the momentum. I mean, Doc sees an opportunity here for them to put their stamp on this game.
And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter. And if it's anything like the first three, we should be in for a treat. And on the floor for the Clippers here in the court, Harrow's Abdul Gallinari, then there's Griffin, then there's Lewis Williams. And it's Teodosic in at the point. Now, here's Poole. Lakers passing it around. Outside Dan. Lopez sends a screen for Dan. Curls the three-pointer. Dan's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Lakers.
Boy, Lopez hunkered down and anchored in on that count.
Griffin against Lopez. Griffin kicks to Williams. The pass to Teodosic. Shots fine on the clock. Fades away. Aaron Ange comes up with the rebound. Look here at the scoring breakdown for the Lakers.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
And they've also worked hard to get the ball inside. They haven't just settled. And they did a lot of high percentage shots in this game.
So against them both, it's a 7-point game.
Job well done. That's a line on that possession. They'll make things a little easier on themselves if they can convert over.
Harrell, that's good.
And no matter what they've tried, the D just has not been able to deny them the ball inside.
Kicks to Lopez. Rebound by Harrell.
Usually if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. Defense to a draw there.
Here's Griffin. Rebounded by the Lakers.
Yeah, exactly. That was lower than low percentage.
And the rebound goes to Griffin. Quickly cleared by the ball. Williams pushes to Griffin. Game moves along. 2 minutes to go here in the fourth. Flanking it by the team. And the win for the Lakers.
And they'll be counting on even more points from him. That's essential if they're going to pull this game.
Absolutely. No question about it. I mean, this is a snub one.
Position changes. Angles checked in for Nance. Ingram comes in for Luol Deng. And Jordan Clarkson in for Brewer. The Clippers also changing it up. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Hill. And it's Clippers in for Williams. Okay, well, let's get out of here.
Kevin has listened in on what Luke Walton said to his team. He said, this is what we play for, fellas. Let's knock them on their heels.
There's 37 seconds left in the fourth. Rivers kicks to Griffin. Down low, here's Jordan. And a foul called on the shot. He's all the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Really out of the right play defensively if you can't block, force him to the line.
Yeah, exactly. Prevent the layup, give him a little bump, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming into the lane next time. And if they don't think about it, at least they might be distracted by your presence.
Second free throw either. It's a goal. And they go to the intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that increases their lead to six.
And really, guys, I can't put a ceiling on England. His length, his shooting stroke, work ethic. This is a guy who I think has the potential to be truly great.
Seconds left here in the fourth quarter. From deep, Gallinari. And Lopez pulls it down. And so the Lakers take the win. They didn't make it easy on themselves.
I mean, there were some times that that momentum shifted, and especially early on, but let's give this group a lot of credit for that stick-to-itiveness in terms of finishing out and executing that game plan.
And that'll do it, folks. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Olsen, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. See you later.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Hey, everybody. Ernie Johnson, along with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal, sitting here. Welcome back for the presentation of our Jordan player of the game, Brook Lopez. You know, tonight he put up his high for the season. Found his rhythm, never let up. Just a terrific scoring effort all the way around. He executed the game plan as a scorer. It was by design that the team was going to try to get him good shots, but it was going to be up to him to make those shots. But I don't think anyone thought he'd make them at that high level of efficiency.
He was dominant, throwing one haymaker after another. And the crowd absolutely loved it. They were eating it all up. It's a love affair between him and this city, especially when he's tearing it up like that. He delivered a beauty tonight.
That's going to do it for our broadcast tonight. We certainly hope you've enjoyed the show, don't we, guys? It was great. Yeah. Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. And for Kevin Harlan and the entire 2K Sports crew, all 653,000 of them, hardworking, a lot of people. The long line at the buffet.
Yeah. Shout out to the T-Poles, man. Oh, I don't know his name, but I know his face.
I'm Ernie Johnson. See you next time.